morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to St. John's Lutheran Church on this All Saints Sunday. So glad that you took time out of your schedules to come and worship our risen Lord and Savior and to remember all of our beloved saints. For those that are worshiping online, my name is Pastor Rick Roberts. Again, thank you for worshiping with us also. Have several announcements, and I guess I should put the announcement first. Welcome, Bishop Kevin Strickland, our Southeastern Synod Bishop. He is with us today. He will be preaching and presiding at Holy Communion, and we're so glad that you are here. So, speaking of All Saints, thanks for everybody who sent in their saints that we will lift up a little bit later in the service, but if you want to add more to that, just if you didn't get a slip, get one and bring it up to the altar during communion, and I think Kathy and Sally will be adding them to our communion connected, what is that called?
Chain.
Yeah, communion chain. And there'll be a little bit more about that in a little bit also. Tonight, first night of Rumanian, so we're starting that season. So thanks for Natalie and Compassion Ministry as we begin this wonderful season to help our unhoused brothers and sisters. How y'all feeling?
Good.
Okay. Let me continue that. How are you feeling about Tuesday?
Anxious.
Anxious. Okay. Terrified, anxious, worried. The bishop and I talked a little bit about that also. So if you are anxious, worried, terrified, whatever, come join us tomorrow night at 7 o'clock in here. We're going to have a service, a prayer service, to try and help us to focus on who and whose we are and, you know, how God will equip us and empower us no matter what happens on Tuesday. So. Oh, and a new ministry today. At the end of the service, 2 weeks ago, Bishop, they surprised me because my birthday was the day after 2 weeks ago. And they sang happy birthday to me and George and some others. And Kathy goes, well, we should do this all the time. So at the beginning of each month, we're going to celebrate the birthdays for the month of November. So after, when the service is over, we'll sing happy birthday and we'll have cake over there to enjoy before we go on to our Sunday school times. Okay, cool. Any announcements that need to come forward? If not, let us rise for confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God in whose image we are made, who claims us and calls us beloved.
Amen.
Holy One,
we confess that we are not awake for you. We are not faithful in using your gifts to share your grace. We forget the least of our siblings, who are beloved saints in your eyes. We do not see your beautiful image of love in one another, which we are all created in. We are affected by sin that divides your beloved community. Open our minds to know your love. Open our eyes to see your love for our neighbors. Open our hands to serve your creation. And open our hearts to see all people as the same as you created us to be. Amen.
Beloved, we are all God's children. And Jesus, our beloved, unbinds us and opens the door to God's kingdom all around us. Through Jesus, you are forgiven. By Jesus, you are welcomed. In Jesus, you are called to rejoice. Let us live as saints to share God's gift of love for all.
Amen.
As you're able, please remain standing for our opening hymn. Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Protect us from all dangers that attack us from the outside, and cleanse us from all evil that arises from within ourselves, that we may be preserved through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated for the hearing of God's word.
First reading is from Isaiah 25, verses 6 through 9. Isaiah sees a vision at the end of days when the Lord will gather all God's people on God's holy mountain and will prepare for them a rich feast. At this banquet, the Lord will wipe the tears from all eyes. There will be no more sorrow, for God will destroy death itself. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-aged wines strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, Lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm will be read responsibly by whole verse. The congregation reads the bold print. Psalm 24. The earth is the Lord and all that is in it, the world and those who dwell therein.
The Lord has founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers.
Who may ascend the mountain of the Lord? Who may stand in God's holy place?
Those of innocent hands and purity of heart, who do not swear on God's being, nor do they pledge by what is false.
They shall receive blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of their salvation.
Such is the generation of those who seek you, O Lord, of those who seek your face, O God of Jacob.
Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, O everlasting doors, that the King of glory may come in.
Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle.
Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, O everlasting doors, that the King of glory may come in.
Who is this King of glory? Truly the Lord of hosts is the King of glory.
The second reading, Revelation 21, 1 through 6. Here is a vision of the new earth and the new heaven and a new earth, in which God resides fully with God's people, so that mourning, despair, and pain have been eradicated. These renewing words from the God who spans all of time are trustworthy and true. I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first earth and the first heaven had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed away. And the one who was seated on the throne said, See, I am making all things new. Also he said, Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true. Then he said to me, It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the gospel reading.
The Holy Gospel according to John, the 11th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Mary came where Jesus was and saw him, she knelt at his feet and said to him, Lord, if you'd been here, my brother would not have died. When Jesus saw her weeping and the Jews who had come with her also weeping, Jesus was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved, and he said, Where have you laid him? They said to him, Lord, come and see. And Jesus began to weep. So the Jews said, See how he loved him. But some of them said, Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind have kept this man from dying? Then Jesus, again greatly disturbed, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone was lying against it. Jesus said, Take away the stone. Martha, the sister of the dead man, said to him, Lord, already there is a stench because he's been dead for 4 days. Jesus said to her, Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God? So they took away the stone. Jesus looked upward and said, Father, I thank you for having heard me. I knew you would always hear me. But I've said this for the sake of the crowd standing here, so they may believe that you sent me. When he said this, he cried out in a loud voice, Lazarus, come out. The dead man came out, and his hands and feet bound with strips of cloth, and his face wrapped in a cloth. And then Jesus said to them, Unbind him and let him go. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated and invite the children forward, please. Excuse me. How is everybody today?
Good.
Yeah, doing good? Did you have a good, did y'all get the trick or treat?
Yeah.
Did it rain?
It rained.
But it didn't stop you, did it? That's a good.
I
bet that is so true.
I got Pokemon cards and it had Umbreon on it, and at the last pack I got Umbreon.
Wow! So you, in spite of the rain, you were still able to have fun. Okay. Hey, I want to introduce you to somebody. There's a couple people actually. Okay. You've never seen these people before. Any idea who those people are? My mom and dad. Yeah. You know, this is the day we call All Saints Sunday. Do you know what that means? Do you mean All Saints means? Saints, you know what saints mean? Yes.
Good people.
Okay. We could go really go somewhere with that one. Because kind of like bad people are saints too. Ooh. Think about that. Yeah, All Saints. My mom and dad, my mom became a saint official on All Saints Sunday 27 years ago. And my dad about 13 years ago. I have a question. Where is heaven? Up there?
Somewhere.
Up there somewhere. Where is heaven? Anywhere where God is. And where is God?
Everywhere.
Everywhere. He's in our hearts, and he's everywhere. So I miss my mom and dad. I really do. But I have them right here in my heart every single day. And that's a wonderful thing about our belief, you know, is that when we die, we're going to be with God wherever God is. But guess what? God's with us right here and right now. Always with us. Always helping. And sometimes we're good, and sometimes we're not so good, right? Yeah. You know, but no matter, God still loves us. God sees us as saints because we are created in God's image, right? And God is always with us. So we're going to lift up a whole bunch of people a little bit later that have been saints to us over the years. And if you can think of someone and you want to write on our communion chain, we have more of those slips and pens, and maybe your parents can help you with that, and we can add those names. Because it could be anybody. It could even be the bishop. Oh my gosh. But, you know, so yes, God is up there, but God is right here. And he loves you so very much every single day of your life. Wouldn't it be cool if everybody knew that? Yeah. We were talking earlier about what could happen in a couple days. And I wish everybody knew that love for us. So maybe we can help tell people about how much God sees them as saints and loves them too. Can you help me pray? Gracious God, thank you for being with us always and everywhere, loving us and helping us. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Cool.
Have a great day.
If I stand here, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, I've got the microphone on, but I'm not sure if it's working.
Yeah.
Oh, it is working. Okay.
It is working.
There you go.
That's right then.
Maybe they turned it down because they didn't want to hear what I had to say. 31 years ago, on All Saints Sunday, someone passed away, and there is not an All Saints that goes by since that I don't think about this person. You see, this guy was sweet and kind. He was a humble man with a gentle spirit and bright blue eyes, the bluest you've ever seen. And when he spoke, they would sparkle. He wasn't a man who was famous. He wasn't well known. He wasn't remembered in history books. But he was a man who was devoted in his life to serving others and his call as a funeral director. As a funeral director, he spent his life in the attention of meeting people mourning in their own Good Fridays, and yet he reminded them that Easter always happens. He would spend his own money to buy clothing and shoes for those families who couldn't afford to bury their loved ones with anything. He reminded me that it was always important to treat people with dignity and love. He reminded me that even in death, all people deserve to be respected and honored and valued. He reminded me that each person was created in the image of God and deserved to be reminded of that. You see, this saint's name was C.B. He was my grandfather. He died on All Saints Day and was buried on All Saints Sunday 31 years ago today. And there's not an All Saints that goes by where I don't think about Saint C.B. Now, he wasn't canonized in the Roman Catholic Church as a saint. My grandmother would have told you that she would never have called him that. But he was a saint nonetheless. He was a saint because he was claimed and named in the waters of holy baptism as the child of God and God's very own. He was a saint because as much as he was a sinner, God had redeemed him. He was a saint because he spent every day of his life walking in death with people, and yet did it because he felt called to be there. You see, for well over 1,000 years, All Saints Day has been used by the church as a way to remember those who have died and gone before us, and yet also those of us who are still here. It's a day that speaks to what Karl Barth said, that it's between what we celebrate as celebrities and who we celebrate as God's very own. Karl Barth said that in order to remember a saint, you have to hold the newspaper in one hand and the Bible in the other, so you don't get confused what a saint is or isn't. To put it more lightly, we often sanctify or sainthood someone based on if they're really good at playing football or if they have a good golf score.
Didn't happen last week.
You're still working on your saintliness. But we make a saint out of people in our own lives. We make them into mega stars, and we think that's what a saint is. Yes, indeed, a saint has nothing to do with that. A saint has everything to do with waking up every day and looking in the mirror and going, I'm a child of God, no less and no more than any other child of God. That's a saint. That's a saint. And so as we sit here today on this All Saints Sunday, we look around and we might be surprised to look into the eyes of another and see there are saints all around us. Now, those of you who are in relationships with one another as family and friends, as church members, you may think, Bishop, now there's some of these folks, I don't know that I'd call them saints. I want you to look deeply into one another's eyes because you have just seen a saint of God, friends. And they have seen you. You see, celebrities distance themselves from their fame, whether it lasts 15 minutes or a lifetime, but saints have a common ground in the open place in the circle of forgiven sinners. The New Testament designation for saints is the forgiven who know it and act upon it and live by grace without angling for stained glass window status. William Stringfellow describes saints as those men and women who relish the event of life as a gift and who realize that the only way to honor such a gift is to give it away. On this All Saints Sunday, we stand again in the graveyards of mourning with Mary and Martha. You heard their plea, didn't you? Lord, if you'd just been here, my brother wouldn't have died. How many times in your life have you stood in your own graveyards, in your own places of mourning and questioning? How many times in your own life have you said, Lord, if you'd just been here. Lord, if you'd just been here, maybe the cancer wouldn't have shown up. Lord, if you'd just been here, maybe the tornado wouldn't have struck our church. Lord, if you'd just been here, fill in the blank. And to that, and to every time we even have to utter that phrase, God in his wonder in the name of Jesus stands before us and says, I've never left. I'm always here in your question and in your doubt, in your graveyard of despair. And on this All Saints Sunday again, we remember with Mary and with Martha that God is a God who wipes away all tears. God is a God who stands in the graveyards of our despairs and our anxiety. God is a God who, even in our anxiousness of wondering what might happen in a national election on Tuesday, reminds us that God is the Alpha and God is the Omega, not who sits behind the resolute desk in Washington, D.C. You heard from Revelation the text that we heard. It's God who sits on the throne, not a man. Not a woman, not a human being, but God. And it's that God that wipes away all tears. It's that God that meets us in our deep hunger. It's that God that reminds us that even in the graveyards we walk through, whether it's a diagnosis, whether it's a child who breaks our heart, whether it's the fear and anxiety of a world gone mad, whether it's destruction around us or death, it's that God that comes so deeply and so nearly and so intricately to you and to me and says to each of us, I am the resurrection and I am the life. Friends, there's a lot of things that are said in this world today, whether it's through a tweet or a Facebook or an Instagram or Snapchat or whatever the rest of that stuff is, and things we say bold enough to one another's face. And yet, what would it look like if we greet every human being as a saint of God, no less, no more, but a beloved child of God that deserves to be told in their graveyard, God is there. After all is said and done, after all the plagues of war and famine and disasters have done their worst, salvation belongs not to generals and dictators and power mongers of this world, but it will always belong to God alone. You can't buy it. You can't earn it. You can't study hard enough for it. It's just given away to you and to you and to you and to the whole world. You see, the thing I love most about All Saints and even our text from John's Gospel today, Lazarus had been dead 4 days. The stench, as it said, was already creeping out of the tomb. And Mary and Martha still were holding on to something. Somehow, life might be what it used to be. Once a dead thing has become dead, you can't bring it back to the way it used to be. But you can certainly breathe new life into it. Did you hear the text? Jesus tells them, you move the stone. You unbind him. You let him go. It didn't say that Jesus did that. Jesus said, you do that. So I wonder in your own lives, what do you need to be unbound from? What do you need to be unbound by? What grave clothes are holding you so desperately in a tomb that you can't live the fullness of God's life that God has prepared for you right now? What tomb door do you need help moving? Because Jesus said, you unbind him. You move that door. So I wonder, St. John's Lutheran Church here in Donelson, Tennessee, on this All Saints Sunday in 2024, what do you need to be unbound from? Maybe it's anxiety. Maybe it's fear. Maybe it's worry. Maybe it's the concern of, am I ever enough? Maybe it's the control over life. Maybe it's the worry of aging. Maybe it's the fear of a disease. Maybe it's just sheerly walking through each day trying to have joy. What do you need to be unbound from and by? What grave clothes do you need to let go of? And how can this community of faith help move the stone? I can tell you it starts with something really simple. Just do it. Just do it. It's not remarkable. It's not angelic. It's not profound. You just got to do it. You do it in small ways. You do it by looking at the face of another person and saying, I see God in you. You do it by reminding people, even at their worst, that they are beloved. You do it by walking with people, even when sometimes they feel as if they can't hold themselves up. You do it because you know what it's like for it to be done for you. So I wonder on this All Saints Sunday, what does it look like to dance with the saints? What does it look like to be in the graveyard where hope has not been lost, where resurrection still happens for you and for me and for this whole world that seems so weary? I'm not a person who's ever without hope. And people ask me all the time when we talk about the decline of this or the decline of that or the this or that. I'm a person who always has great hope, but my hope does not rest in mortals. My hope does not rest in bank accounts. My hope does not rest in how many people show up to church or who don't show up to church. My hope rests in God. That's where your hope should rest. In the God who can raise a man from the dead, and a God who can remind you your life is worth living, and a God who says, be unbound and run. Run in the resurrection life. Don't be held by these grave clothes anymore. That's the God we know. And as a church, we don't suffer amnesia about our saints. Because friends, if the saints before can walk through life and live through it and can teach us something better about our own, we need not ever forget them. Each and every week when we come to this table, we are surrounded by our grandparents and our mothers and our fathers and those Sunday school teachers and loved ones that have gone before us. And each and every time we hear, this is the body of Christ given for you, right then and there, we're dining with them. With mom and dad, with grandpa, with sisters and brothers and people we've never met. You see, at this table, there are no grave clothes. At this table, there are no bindings. At this table, you are welcome freely as you are, and yet are given life anew. So we don't know what's going to happen on Tuesday. We don't know what's going to happen an hour from now. But what we do know is this. The God in whom we place our faith, the God in whom we know our trust, rest not in mortals, but rest in the hope of the resurrection, which is already happening. So friends, whatever you need to be unbound from, leave it here. Whatever grave clothes you're holding on to, let go of it. And run from this tomb today, spreading the good news that Jesus is resurrection and life for you and for the whole world. Amen. Thank you.
profess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The peace of the risen Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Please take a couple of moments to share God's peace with one another.
The church, and all of creation. O God of resurrection, you call us by name and raise us to life. Rouse your church from slumber. Where we have held back in fear or shame, unbind us. Embolden us in our proclamation of your good news, that all may know abundant life. Merciful God.
Hear our prayer.
O God of creation, you have founded your world on rivers and seas. Preserve fresh water sources and the creatures who call them home. Heal places of pollution and nourish places of drought. Merciful God.
Hear our prayer.
O God of the earth, you reign over all nations and peoples. Inspire us with wisdom and discernment as we elect legislators and leaders. May they govern with justice and uphold the dignity of all people. Merciful God.
Hear our prayer.
O God of heaven, you make your home among mortals. Come alongside those who weep this day. Befriend all who are lonely, encourage those in despair, and heal any who are suffering, especially those on our prayer sheet and all those we lift up to you with our voices and in our hearts now.
Would you lift up Michael Campbell as he prepares for some type of treatment for his cancer?
Abide with your faithful ones in love. Merciful God.
Hear our prayer.
O God who serves, you set before us a feast of rich food. Sustain our ministries of fellowship, and hospitality. Strengthen the hearts and hands of all who prepare and serve food for our nourishment. Merciful God.
Hear our prayer.
O God, Alpha and Omega, we give thanks for your thankful and faithful ones who are now at peace with you. With all your saints, we praise you, for you have swallowed up death forever. Merciful God.
Hear our prayer.
We offer our prayers to you, gracious God, trusting in your boundless love for all that you have made, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Amen.
Mercedes Ackerman, Londa Adams, Doug Adams, Marjorie Aldridge, Frank Aldridge Sr., Edna Anderson, Frank Anderson, Peter Ardagna Jr., Peter Ardagna Sr., Margaret Vaselli,
Jim Bailey, Theda Bailey, Elizabeth Mackenzie Bailey, James Philip Bailey III, Ed Barger, Scott Barger, Leslie Barger, Adeline Barger, Don Bertelson, Mary Bertelson.
Doris Billman, Ron Billman, Wilbur Billman, Joel Bodenow, Rita Brady, Catherine Brandt, George Brandt, Stephen Harold Brown, Cynthia Ann Kane, Pete Cardinal.
David Carlson, Patrick Cartwright, Lane Conrad, John Crow, Bessie Crow, Thomas Crow, Nita Davis, Paul Denard, Tony Dresch, Jerry Dresch Sr.
Eleanor Druyer, Todd Doobie, Walter Doobie, James G. Duggar, Glenn Duggar, Lois J. Duggar, Sybil Duggar, Joel Emerson, Beverly Emerson, Stephen Emerson.
Perennial for Pharaoh, Mary Pharaoh, William Gamble Sr., Sue Geist, Bob Glover, Virginia Glutch, John Glutch, Bill Golden, Daniel M. Graham.
David Graham, Lynn Grantham, Caroline Graybosch, Thomas Graybosch, Dylan Blake Gregg, Ann Gregg, George Gross, Helen Gross, Dusty Herring, Bob Harris.
Elsie Harris, Henry Harris, Lois Ann Harris, James Harris, Robert Hazelton, Rose Hazelton, Mark Hill, Olive Hill, Alvin Johnson, Brenda Johnson.
Clarence Johnston, David Doc Johnson, Elsie Johnson, Ethel Johnson, Jim Jones, Juanita Jones, Hope Cahill, Don Cahill, Gwen Cahill, Natasha Catunia.
Yuri Kotlov, Edward LaCourte, Mary LaCourte, Rose LaCourte, Nancy Harris Landis, Richard Larson, Lainey Lemmel, Raymond Leslie, Sue Leslie, Wanda Libby.
Merlin Littlefield, Marguerite Ludeman, Margaret Ludeman, Carl Ludeman, John Luxus, Margie Luxus, Gordon Lyman, Louise Lyman, Mabel Moss McLean, Bob Marchese.
Susan Miscata, Tony Mubarak, Marie Nerg, Lavinia Onby, Homer Onby, Arlen Paff, Carrie Paff, Leslie Paff, Penny Parshall, David Paulus.
Rebecca Paulus, Helen Phillips, Walter Phillips, Tommy Pogue, Richard Price, Mildred Price, Melissa and Larry Price, Ann Pride, Bessie Roberts, Pody Roberts.
Charlie Roberts Jr., Charlie Roberts Sr., Bill Rumor, Marie Rumor, Louis Sanders, Geneva Sanders, Vanessa Schmidt, Bill Sins, Doris Sins, Ed Sins.
Dan Skillbred, Mike Smith, Tiffany Smith, Kathleen Terry, Joseph Terry, Unita Thornton, Linda Timmer, Myrtle Toomey, Harold Tyler, Pearl Tyler.
W.C. Vaughn, Fred Warren, Helena Wilson, Irene Wine, David Winthrop, Joan Winthrop, George W. Young, Joanne Gillians Young.
Master Sergeant William Michael Young, George E. Young, Beulah Nash Young, Master Sergeant Donald E. Young, Martha Young.
your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who rose from the dead, and in whom our hope of resurrection dawns. The sting of death has been removed by the glorious promise of his risen life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "This is the new covenant of my blood, given and shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." We pray together the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Invites you to the table. Come, eat, be satisfied. Come to the table where all are welcome and
all meets all.
For those online, this is Christ's body and blood, God's love given and shed for you. As Bishop said in his sermon about the table where everyone is welcomed and where everybody is, I think on All Saints Sunday is the most one of the most appropriate days to have communion because we're communing with all people of all time. My mom and dad and your loved ones are communing. We're all together in this one sacrament that brings us together. So take a moment and think about your loved ones and that they are here. They are with us, communing with us. I don't see any visitors, so you pretty much know the rules. Just come right down the center aisle. And if you have saints you want to be added to our chain, please give them to Kathy or Sally. Come, all is prepared.
Father,
body of Christ broken, given for you. 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 The body of Christ broken, given for you. The body of Christ broken, given for you. Body of Christ broken, given for you. The body of Christ broken, given for you. The body of Christ broken, given for you. 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 Body of Christ broken, given for you.
The body of Christ broken, given for you.
The body of Christ broken, given for you. Body of Christ broken, given for you. Body of Christ broken, given for you. May you always know the truth. Body of Christ broken, given for you. Body of Christ broken, given for you.
Body of Christ
broken, given for you. Body of Christ broken, given for you. Body of Christ broken, given for you. May you always know your love. Body of Christ broken. Body of Christ broken, given for you. May you always know that you're loved. Body of Christ broken, given for you. May you always know your love. Body of Christ broken, given for you. Body of Christ broken, given for you. Body of Christ broken, given for you. The body of Christ broken, given for you. Body of Christ broken for you. May you always know that you're loved. Body of Christ broken for you. Body of Christ broken for you. Body of Christ broken for you. The body of Christ is broken for you. The body of Christ broken for you. And blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you, keep you in his grace.
Amen. Amen.
With praise and thanksgiving to God.
Jesus, bread of life, we have received from your table more than we could ever ask. As you have nourished us with this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with your own life, with our own life. In your name we pray.
Amen. Amen. The blessing of God who provides for us, feeds us, and journeys with us be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen.
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 Peterson, Dale Conway, Molly Hine, Joaquin Toon, Mike Farrow, and our bishop.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Good to see you, Rhonda.